Suppose that f of x is a continuous function with f of 1 equals negative 4 and f of 5 equals 3. Determine which choice best describes the following statement. F of x equals 0 for some x in the closed interval from 1 to 5. And our choices are always false, sometimes true and sometimes false, always true. Notice the closed interval from 1 to 5 come from the inputs of the function. And notice how the outputs, or the function values, are opposite signs. One's negative and one's positive. If f of 1 equals negative 4, our continuous function must pass through the point 1 comma negative 4. And if f of 5 equals 3, it must also pass through the point 5 comma 3. So the key here is that our function is continuous, and it must pass through these two points. Let's take a look at this on a graph. If our function is continuous, that means we must be able to sketch it passing through these two points without lifting up our pencil. So it should make sense if we sketch our continuous function passing through these two points, it must cross the x-axis at least once, and the x-axis is where the function values would be 0. So our function might look something like this. Notice here, f of 4 equals 0, and 4 would be in this closed interval. But there may actually be more than one x value in this interval where the function value would be 0. We can sketch a continuous function over this interval with more than one x-intercept. For example, the function might also look something like this. And notice in this case, there are three x values in this closed interval where the function value would be 0. Here at x equals 2, 3, and 4. So regardless of how many x values are in this interval, such that f of x equals 0, there must be at least one because the function is continuous. So the best choice would be always true. Let's take a look at a similar question. Here we're told that f of x is a function with f of negative 1 equals negative 3 and f of 6 equals 2. Notice here we're not told the function is continuous. Determine which choice best describes the following statement. Again, f of x equals 0 for some x in the closed interval from negative 1 to 6. Once again, notice that negative 1 and 6 are the given inputs, and the outputs of the function values have opposite signs. If f of negative 1 equals negative 3, then the function must contain the point negative 1 comma negative 3, and if f of 6 equals 2, the function must also contain the point 6 comma 2. Let's take a look at this on the graph as well. Again, we're not told the function is continuous. It may or may not be continuous. We know if it is continuous and it passes through these two points, there must be at least some x value in this interval where the function value would be 0. For example, here, the function value would be 0 at x equals 3. But what if the function is not continuous? Could we sketch a non-continuous function over this closed interval that does not pass through the x-axis? And the answer is yes, we could. It might look something like this. Could pass through this point here, have a break in the graph at 4, and then begin at 4 again above the x-axis, let's say here. Notice how we do have a function. It passes through the given points based upon the given function values, but there is not an x value such that f of x equals 0. Which means in this case, our best choice would be it could be sometimes true and sometimes false, based upon whether the function is continuous or not. So this idea leads us to what's called the intermediate value theorem. The intermediate value theorem states that if our function f is continuous on a closed interval from a to b, and k is any real number between f of a and f of b, then there is at least one number c in this closed interval from a to b such that f of c equals k. As an illustration, let's take a look at this function here. Let's consider this function on the closed interval from negative 3 to 3, or from here to here. Looking at this point on the function, notice f of negative 3 equals negative 2. And considering this point on the function when x equals 3, notice how f of 3 equals positive 2. So now we're going to pick a value k between f of a and f of b, or in this case, between negative 2, and positive 2. Now in our previous examples, we considered the function value of 0, but it doesn't have to be the function value of 0. Let's say we considered the function value of positive 1. We'll notice how y equals positive 1, or f of x equals 1, would be anywhere along this horizontal line. And notice on the closed interval from negative 3 to 3, there are actually 3x values in this closed interval where the function value would be positive 1. The function value is positive 1 here, here, and here. And therefore the values of c, or the values of x in the closed interval with a function value of positive 1, would be here, here, and here. And these x values are guaranteed by the intermediate value theorem as long as the function is continuous on the closed interval from a to b, or in our case from negative 3 to 3. I hope you found this helpful.